All right, here we go. Quiet!
Quiet! Quiet!
Problem!
The Long Shot was directed by Jennifer Levy and stars Charlize Theron, Seth Rogen, O'Shea Jackson, and Andy Serkis. And it's a rom-com movie. And this movie is about Charlize Theron is a Secretary of State, Seth Rogen is a journalist, they are childhood friends, and they meet up again in life, and Seth Rogen starts working for Charlize Theron as a writer for her speeches. Now, normally, I'm not a big rom-com movie fan. I went to see it because I like Charlize Theron, I love Seth Rogen, it's really funny. And this movie actually is legitimately funny. Seth Rogen is always as hilarious, Charlize Theron has some funny moments in it too. This is really work. Seth Rogen and Charlize Theron have good chemistry in the movie, what I found was really good in the movie. Like, Seth Rogen is the best part of this movie, like, he always has the funniest parts. It's just the way he does everything is just hilarious, especially at the beginning of the movie. There's this one sequence where he has a journalist, he's investigating this group, and it's hilarious. It's hilarious and funny, and it's the type of comedy you expect in a movie. But this is what I say, the chemistry between them is good, and what was interesting to see, the movie doesn't go the stereotypical route of a normal rom-com. Like, you know, like a lot of movies do, they actually sift away. Like, it doesn't go the normal route like you would do. Like, you know, somebody finds out, oh, this will never work, and then the person's heartbroken, and this whole emotional... It doesn't go that route. It takes it whole differently. What was actually refreshing to see, and that was fun to see, to go it in not in a different type of way. So that was fun and actually interesting to see, like, a different way of showing a rom-com instead of doing the same stuff that every other movie does. But this is also a problem at the same time, because at times it does go the traditional route and it doesn't want to exactly. Like, this is the problem. The movie doesn't know which way exactly to go. Like, to shift completely different and do nothing like the traditional stuff, or no, let's do some of the traditional tropes that you see in other rom-com movies. And that was like the struggle, because you kind of feel like it goes this route. It's like, oh, this is new. And no, it goes back to the stuff we know, what's expected. Oh yeah, we know what's going to happen now. Which eventually does, which was okay, but it's kind of mixed in tone. Like, they're trying to do something new, but then it goes back to old, new, this way. It doesn't work actually completely. And I also think the movie didn't actually know what to basically do, because they travel from point A, but in the movie, the two characters travel around for this paper that Charlize Theron character wants to sign, all the countries and everything, and that's actually fun. But once that's over, the movie doesn't actually know. That's when the movie like fell in the traditional tropes, because like, okay, we did that, okay, we did that, what's actually different, and yeah, what are we gonna do now? Oh, just do everything what's expected basically to see in those movies, and with a few changes. But this movie is fun. Like I said before, the comedy is good in this movie. O'Shea Jackson is really, he's my favorite in the movie. He really has some hilarious lines, him and Seth Rogen. And Andy Serkis, I didn't know it was Andy Serkis until I saw the credits. It's like Andy Serkis, because I saw this character, this other senator, rich guy, and it's like, he looks like Andy Serkis, but I'm not sure, because he has so much makeup on him and everything. It's just like, so that was unexpected, but he was fun in the movie. Like I said, the movie is fun. The movie doesn't go to traditional route as a rom-com for most of the time. Sometimes it does. That's when the movie kind of like shifts in tone. It doesn't always work. But other than that, the movie is fun. Now, normally I grade this movie like in the American alphabet system, but I remember my friend told me, yeah, I watch your reviews, but I don't really know what your grade means, because he doesn't know all the system like I do. So I thought about like, that's actually true. So I'm gonna try something different. I'm gonna do from 10 to 10. So I'm gonna give this movie a 7 out of 10. I'm gonna try this grading system for a little bit. Maybe I like it, maybe I not, maybe I will change it completely. But like, for the moment, I'm gonna give this movie 7 out of 10. Long Shot. Check it out if you want to. It's a fun movie. Thanks everybody for watching, and as always, see you next time.